At the New Israel Baptist Church, Pastor Douglas Haywood preaches about the power of the ballot box.
Now we're trying to encourage the rest of the people to get out and vote. It's very, serious.
Like many church leaders, he's focused on inspiring young people to get involved in politics, but he's also acutely aware that it can be an uphill battle.
I think voters are one of the most important things that there is because of our forefathers having such a hard time not voting at all and had a desire to. Now here we are, we have an opportunity to vote, and some people don't want to vote.
National campaigns like the one from Rock the Vote are aimed at changing that, but even star-studded viral videos may have limited effect. While El Halabi is a 25-year-old musician who moved to New Orleans more than a year ago, he's had plenty of chances to register to vote, and whilst he's aware of the midterm elections, they haven't piqued his interest. Like many young voters, he doesn't feel like there's anything at stake for him.
Probably if there was like someone who was like going to be elected, and he was like saying, oh, if I get elected, I'm going to make street musicians' lives amazing. And I'm like, hell yeah, okay, it's time to go vote for this guy, because, you know, it directly affects my life. But right now, I don't see that.
Despite that, Louisiana has one of the highest rates of young voters in the U.S., but academics say midterm elections simply don't hold the same appeal as presidential elections.
If they're not really seeing results from the two parties, and it's not a big election and there's not a presidential race on the ballot, they just sometimes just feel like it's not worth their time to come out to vote.
The so-called millennial generation then has a powerful electoral voice in Louisiana. But here and elsewhere, young voters are increasingly shunning midterm voting.
According to the U.S. Census Bureau, the number of young voters who turned out to the midterm elections in 1964 stood at just over 50%. But by 2012, that figure had dropped to 38%. That equates to the loss of tens of thousands of young voices who, in an election this close, could make all the difference. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, New Orleans, Louisiana.